It's hot, it's fiery. It's a story of love and hate. A bundle of contradictions. It protects and attacks. It hurts but heals. The identity of India that comes from a foreign land. This is the enticing story of a spoonful of pain. The air is acrid, tempers frayed. Amidst mounds of red, buyers and sellers haggle. Chili commands a very special respect in our spice markets. The sellers assertive, the buyers choosy. India, the largest producer and exporter of the spice that literally breathes fire. Our exploration of this fiery spice begins on the ship of Christopher Columbus. It was the age of discovery. The search for spices was on. Columbus sailed from Portugal to look for India and pepper. Reached America instead and discovered not black pepper but chili. Confusing the hot chili with black pepper, Columbus named the fiery spice chili pepper. Chili was chili, not pepper, a spice unknown to most of the world back then. India too had not tasted chili at that time. Chili originated in South America nearly 6,000 years ago. But it was the Portuguese that spread chili globally, from its home to the rest of the world.
Certainly in India, it's exotic. It is not Indian in origin. And the chili pepper has a very long history, which also involves Christopher Columbus and many interesting personages.
The exotic spice chili, just 5 centuries old in India. It's a love story that blossomed in each and every kitchen, with almost no exception. No wonder then, India has become synonymous with chili. The curry nation consumes 10 lakh tons of chili each year.
आदमी चाहे आंसू बहाए चाहे कुछ कहे लेकिन वो बिना मिर्ची के तो नहीं खा सकता. Impossible है. कोई टेस्ट ही नहीं रह जाएगा.
An entire family of plants cooks in the pan. Potatoes, tomatoes, brinjal and chili from the same Solanaceae family, the nightshades. Chili is the fruit of plants belonging to the capsicum genus. Capsicum comes from the Greek word capsimo, meaning to bite. But Indians had not been bitten by the chili till just 500 years ago. It was the European sailors who introduced us to their loved spice, when they came for trade.
People actually, first of all, rejected that because the pungency was never been a part of our culture.
Indians till then had only used black pepper or ginger to add a delicate sting to their meals. The fiery chili was unpalatable. The Portuguese wanted it, but Indians refused to grow it. To break the stalemate, the chili lovers attributed to it super magical powers.
These Portuguese people introduced chili plant into that particular thing, that this is having a pungent taste which is very tikha, and if you are going to plant this plant in your farm, that evil spirit will run away.
Superstition always dies a natural death, but chili was a winner. In a span of little more than 500 years, chili has become indispensable in the Indian kitchen. The versatile cross-pollinating plant took to the Indian soil and climate. Today, India is by far the biggest producer of chili, with more than 10 lakh hectares of land growing the fiery spice. Chili adopted India, occupied land, evolved. Today, it grows in a number of states. India is considered the secondary center of origin of chili because of its tremendous diversity in the country. Each of these states producing a diverse variety of chilies. Diversity in color, shape, pungency. Why would a plant choose pungency? Why would a bite suit its makeup? How and when did the chili become hot? With these very questions, we arrive at the Indian Institute of Science, Bengaluru, the Biological Sciences Department, a hub of activity. A multidisciplinary team researching the unique relationships that exist in nature. The interplay of life for survival and evolution.
If I were to take the biology of the chili pepper first, the gene for the hotness, probably there was a single mutation or a single point which gave capsaicin, and the subsequent descendant species all acquired capsaicin because of their ancestry.
A single mutation in the gene, from non-spicy to hot. The fire in chili was born. Its chemistry changed. Something that meant it could still be friends with the birds that dispersed its seed.
Kage bekas kare idu kage tintade. Kage khare agudilla. Kage khare idu manasanne tinnudechu.
Birds cannot sense the fire in chili. No pain, just gain. They love the colorful fruit packed with vitamins. But mammalian herbivores can sense its heat. Herbivores that are the plant's enemies. While feeding, they would crush the seed and destroy it. An interesting co-evolution. Chili selected a favorable trait for survival. Something that made sure its enemies stayed away, but friends near. Chili seeds are softened in the guts of the birds during digestion. Softened but intact. They travel to faraway lands and get deposited in rich bird droppings. So chilies not just traveled with the Portuguese sailors, they flew with birds. But the story of evolution and survival, never without subplots. Researchers across the world have proved beyond doubt the antifungal and antimicrobial effect of the spice in chili, a mutation that guards it against harmful soil microbes. So what makes chili pungent? Inside the fruit are a unique group of compounds, the capsaicinoids. Of these, the most important one is capsaicin. Greater its concentration, hotter the chili. Capsaicin lies in the placenta, the white membrane to which the seeds are attached. Some heat is transferred to the seeds by contact but definitely not stored in them. When we bite into a chili, this is what happens.
When you put them in the mouth, they have a pungent taste. They certainly interact with the receptors and create that, if I can call, violent sensation.
Heat and pain, that's what chili causes. The chemistry of this spice different from our flavor sensations. When food reaches our mouth, the taste buds covering the tongue pick up the molecules. Sweet, sour, salty, bitter, it's a chemical sense. Different flavors lock onto specific receptors and the nerves carry the information to the brain. This works for all tastes, but chili is different. It's not a taste, but a sensation of pain, heat. The colorless, odorless, flavorless compound, capsaicin, tricks our nervous system. The mouth's pain receptors pick up the sensation, not the taste buds, but pain receptors. The information is carried to the brain. The brain interprets and signals the body. The body responds. The heart starts beating faster. The body tries to cool down. Blood surges. Sweat appears. A runny nose, watery eyes, and the body cools. Capsaicin also releases endorphins in the body, the feel-good hormones, a sense of happiness.
मिर्ची एक टंग फ्लेवर टेस्ट है ना, तो जबान को जब मिर्ची लगे तो अपना आदमी खा सकता, अगर मिर्ची नहीं तो नहीं खा सकता, मिर्ची हो नमक हो नहीं तो नहीं खा सकता आदमी।
Why do chili and children not go together? The answer lies in this very perception of heat and pain. Our bodies get accustomed to the hotness, learn to like it gradually. How is it for those who work with chili? How does their body, their skin, take the heat and burning?
शुरू शुरू में जरा मिर्ची ये करता डेट निकालता था ना तो हाथ में बहुत जलन होती थी दर्द अभी नहीं होता है पहले आदत हो गई है ना 28 साल से मेरे को आदत हुई है अभी काम करने में बहुत मजा आता है
The heat of chili is perceived by the pain receptors all over the skin. Gradually, the skin gets used to it. The spice box in the Indian kitchen is incomplete without the red hot chili powder. Ripe mature chilies are spread out in the sun to dry. What seems like a mundane job of grinding dried chilies is actually a skilled one. Different varieties of chilies mixed in to blend in the right color and pungency. The consumer choosy about this spoonful of pain. Mumbai has an entire lane dedicated to chili. The Mirchi Gali equipped to handle the very varied tastes.
और मिर्ची पीकर तो जिंदगी नहीं है. लुखा खाना कितने दिन खाएगी? मिर्ची पहला चाहिए.
Buyer or seller, pungency has come to be liked. For the common man, pungency is very often judged by trial and error. But in today's world of scientific precision, numbers matter. Grades needed to measure. And research with chili brings in its own challenges.
तो हमें पहले मास्क पहनना पड़ता है, फिर ग्लव्स, ऐसे लैब कोट पूरा पूरा कवर करना पड़ता है थोड़ा सा भी अगर लग जाता है मैं आंख या कहीं भी हो वो जलने लगता है और हालत बहुत खराब कर देता है
Chili has a scale of pungency, a measure for hotness. The Scoville scale, devised by an American scientist, Wilbur Scoville. Chili is mixed in sugar solution. The pungency measured by the dilution at which the human tongue can perceive it. It needs to be hotter than 107.6 degrees Fahrenheit or 42 degrees Celsius. While capsicum stands at zero, no pungency, the reading increases with different varieties. At the top, the bite of fire, Bhutsulakya, the Naga chili from northeast India.
It's having very high capsaicin to the extent of 10 to 12 lakhs SHU units of pungency. It's very hot, and even doing powdering in the lab itself is very difficult.
Bhutsolakya, the Naga chili, occupies a place of honor in the hotness chart. Its pungency is intolerable even to the most avid chili lover. One single chili, supposedly enough to add a big kick to a meal of 200. Lal mirchi, khara pudi, longka marich, mulaku, me lagai marcha. It's a love-hate relationship. Can't do without it. Chili powder by any name spells hot.
Mirchi andar jala di hai, aag bahar se jala di hai.
When the mouth is burning, it's a bad idea to drink water. Water actually spreads the heat all over the mouth, making it worse. What helps is milk, curd, or cream. Is this love for the spoonful of pain good for us or bad? What is the truth? Does it really cause ulcers? Acidity, loose motions, hair fall, and loss of eyesight, as commonly believed.
ऐसा देखे जाए तो मिर्ची तीखी और लाल चाहिए बेस्ट. उसके अलावा खाने के लिए तो अच्छी है, लेकिन काफी जने कहना है कि भाई इससे अल्सर होता है काफी तेज खाने से.
Myths are dangerous. Lack of information harmful. We seek answers at the CFTRI Mysore, a dedicated team of food technologists working out of a grand palace, an entire department dedicated to research in spices.
Myth has been dispensed off. Capsaicin is a drug. Certainly it doesn't cause ulcer. It acts as anti-ulcer agent.
Scientists world over have proven beyond doubt that the antibacterial action of chili safeguards our intestines from ulcers by destroying the very bacteria responsible for it. In fact, it protects the intestines and even promotes digestion. In another interesting experiment, the anti-inflammatory property of chili has been studied. Rats were fed chili powder rich in capsaicin over a period of time. Inflammation was then induced in their paws. The pre-treated rats showed lesser inflammation, better recovery. Capsaicin is finding use in managing pain, especially in age-related problems like arthritis. Several gels and balms containing capsaicin have been developed. When applied, they induce a series of reactions. The body releases endorphins, the natural painkiller. Also blocks pain messages, bringing relief. Its use, however, should be on medical advice. The fiery chili, often discredited, packs in quite a healthy punch. It also improves circulation and prevents blood clots. Its health potential becomes vast with its very special properties.
Capsaicin is the only food molecule in the globe it is documented and reported to say it will increase your thermogenic process in your body.
In the battle against obesity, chili could be a friend. Our chili yatra brings us to the cool city Bengaluru, where the hot spice is center stage. IIHR has a multi-pronged chili breeding program, developing disease resistance, drought tolerance, better high-yielding varieties is their aim. An impressive germplasm of chili is maintained here, a scientific effort to create safer crop for the farmer. Crossbreeding is an exciting labor of love.
Me, it is a highly variable crop. It is very beautiful to see the variability of chili. As a breeder, I enjoy when I sow that seed, the type of plant I get, the type of fruits I get, it will be very exciting.
While institutes are trying to save chili, chili has saved many. Its use for defense and offense, well documented in history. Pre-independence Bengal riots. Women poured water spiked with chili to drive away the rioters. In today's world, when young girls find themselves unsafe, chili becomes a handy deterrent. Chili powder from the kitchen bolsters courage.
एक लड़का मुझे बहुत परेशान करता था और मेरे को बहुत तेज गुस्सा आता था. मेरे को मेरे दिमाग में आया कि मिर्ची पाउडर लेके उसकी आँख में डाल दूँ और मैं रोज अपने बस्ते में रखती थी.
The Defence Research Development Organisation (DRDO) has in fact developed a novel and non-lethal weapon for use. The Capsi spray uses capsaicin for defence and safety. From crime to conflict, chili is taking many avatars. This is elephant land. These villages lush with bananas, cane, coconuts. Food that attracts the mighty beast. Resolving the conflict is chili. Farmers have been trained to protect their crop from the raiding elephants. Chili paste and waste oil is all it takes. Ropes around the standing or harvested crop are smeared with this pungent mix.
Namge adrinda aap aur paadige idre adu sneha adu bandu tindkondu hodkodle adu dushman aagutade.
The farmers who would be compelled to harm the elephant are now using the fire of chili to keep them away. The elephant extremely sensitive to the hotness of the spice. While chili smeared ropes work short distance, it's the acrid chili smoke that the elephants sense from far away. Waste chili packed between dry straw and coconut husk. A contraption that costs next to nothing. When darkness descends, the bundles, tied strategically, are burnt. They burn slowly. The acrid smoke spreads far.
ಆನೆ ಹೆಚ್ಚಾಗಿ ನಾವು ಹೊಗೆನೇ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೆ ಮುಂದೆ ಜಲ್ದಿ ಫಾಸ್ಟ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ ಅದು ಆನೆ ಬಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಇಮಿಡಿಯೇಟ್ಲಿ 5 ಮಿನಿಟ್ಸ್
ಫಾರ್ಮರ್ಸ್ ರಿಪೋರ್ಟ್ ದಟ್ ಎಲಿಫೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಸ್ನೀಸ್ ಕಾಫ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಲೀವ್ ಇಮಿಡಿಯೇಟ್ಲಿ ದಿ ಎಲಿಫೆಂಟ್ ಸೇಫ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಹ್ಯೂಮನ್ ರಾತ್. The farmer and his crop safe.
So when they are able to save their crops using such simple low-tech solutions like chili smoke or chili rope, it is a win-win situation for both.
It's a win-win situation. And center stage is chili. Our spice box is an ancient journey. The journey of food and taste, nutrition, health and wellness. The hot chili, a cool spice, a wise spice. Do send us your reactions and feedback by email or post our address. Vigyan Prasar, A50, Institutional Area, Sector 62, Noida, 201309. Our email, info@vigyanprasar.gov.in.